This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Video.
Hey guys, it's Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to Copycat Friday! Janik! Damn! Your hands taste bad! By the way, I'm doing the presentation, Janik. Janik!
Hey guys!
Hey guys, it's Janik here for Cinecom.net, and it feels good to be out of Jordy's body. It was getting a little bit crowded in there. And smelly. I think he ate something funny. But now that I'm free and here, let's get ready for a new Copycat Friday. A series where we recreate effects from famous movies and music videos. And today we are having a look at Rich Brian's latest music video, Yellow. It was directed by Dave Myers, so you can already know it's going to be an awesome music video. And it doesn't disappoint. In the music video you can see a few scenes where Rich Brian gets possessed by something and it wants to leave his body. I'm a huge fan of these effects, and that's why we decided to recreate these skin displacements in this week's Copycat. To be specific, we are recreating the choking shot and the whole body possession. Another thing I'm a super fan of is our sponsor Storyblocks Video. It's an online library that's full with high quality stock clips, After Effects templates, transitions, and so much more. We always say that we use Storyblocks Video in every project we do. Well, that isn't a lie. We love the huge selection that Storyblocks Video delivers, and also that you can download unlimited assets for only one price per year. So if you want to check out Storyblocks Video and start downloading right away, click in the first link in the description below. Okay, Lorenzo, cue the montage.
Janik, catch!
Almost.
Janik! Janik, can you help? Janik, can you take the box cutter out of my pocket?
It's what did you do, Tony?
Can you take the box cutter?
What's this?
Now let's continue.
Whoa, you really went all the way there, Lorenzo. Nice job. But as you can see, we recreated the set from Rich Brian's music video. Or the look and feel at least. So now it's time to making the shots. We are first going to start with a shot for the choking effect. Simply put your camera on a tripod and choose your frame. We decided to put the camera slightly higher than our actor filming down on him. Also, we went in real close, and this will make the effect much easier, because we cut into the hand and don't have to remove it afterwards. Now let your actor grab his own throat, but tell him to use the hand where the thumb is farthest removed from the camera. So in our case, it's Jordy's left hand. Press the arm as close as possible to the body and make the shot. Oh yeah, one last thing. Don't let your actor talk too much. This will make the blending of everything much harder. With our shot done, let's jump into After Effects. Take your shot in the project panel and drag it into a newer composition. The first thing we are going to do is duplicate the shot. You can simply do that by hitting Ctrl D. Next up is the tracking of the movement. Select the lower choking shot and head over to the right side of After Effects. Here you can find the tracker panel. Open it up and select the track motion. Next up, select the rotation and scale options. This will give you an extra tracking point, which you are going to need for a good tracking. Place the tracking points on recognizable elements. For our shot, we use the nails of Jordy's hand. Once you place the tracking points, you can hit Analyze Forward. Let After Effects do its thing, and when it's done, we need to link it to something. So let's create a null object. Go up to the layer menu on top, select New and choose Create a Null Object. Go back to the tracker panel and click on Edit Target. Here you can now select the null object and press OK. Press Apply and voila, your shot is tracked. Next up is making the hand look like it's underneath the skin. It isn't that hard, but it's quite some work. We are going to use the clone stamp tool from After Effects. This is a tool where you can copy or clone a part of the scene and paste it somewhere else. To start, select the duplicate of the choking shot. Right-click on it, go to time and choose freeze frame. Now with it still selected, double-click on it. This will take you to the layer panel where you can start the painting. But before we can paint, let's set some settings. On the right side of After Effects, you have the brushes and the paint panel. We are going to need them both, because in the brushes panel, you can choose your brush and the size of it. Select one that is medium of size and has zero hardness. Now go to the paint panel and set the opacity to 60%. We do this to make the blending more smooth. Okay, now we can start with painting in the layer panel. If you want to select a part from the skin that you want to copy, just hold the Alt key and click on the part of the skin. Now After Effects will remember where you clicked. So if you now paint, you are using the skin you selected as your ink. But as you can see, if you make large movements when painting, then the selecting area will also do the same movements. And this is not something we want, because it will copy parts we don't want to use. So I recommend to make smaller movements, changing the brush size and the opacity, and regularly reselecting the part of skin you want to copy. This reselecting will also make the blending of everything more smooth. Now you can completely blend in the hand with the neck, so that it looks like it's underneath the skin. This means removing every edge of your hand and making it smooth as the rest of the skin. I'll admit, you are going to need a lot of clone stamping to do so, but it will be worth it. After you are done with clone stamping, the hand will probably look too flat, but we can fix that with some regular brushes. Inside the paint effect, disable all the clone stamping brushes you created. This will leave you with the original shot. Now take the brush tool in the toolbar on top and go back to the layer panel. Now we are going to recreate the shadow and highlight parts of your hand. In the paint panel, set your opacity to around 8%. For the brush size, take again something medium. Because we are going to start with the highlight parts, you can also set the mode to screen. Now in the layer panel, you can again start painting. Hold the Alt key to select the color of your highlights and paint everywhere where you can see a highlight. Now do exactly the same for the shadows, except here you need to change the mode in the paint panel to multiply. After you have done all of the painting, you normally have this super cool looking hand underneath the skin. However, because we freezed it, we need to bring back the motion into it. But luckily, this is super simple. Just select the clone stamping layer, right-click on it and select Pre-compose. Make sure you select Move all attributes into a new composition and hit OK. Now select the pre-compose layer and take the pen tool to create a mask. You can mask quite close to the edge of the hand. When done, go back to the toolbar on top and select the mask feather tool. With this tool, you can determine how and where to feather the mask. Select a point on your mask and drag it outwards to feather. Now the last thing you need to do is just simply link the clone stamping layer to the null object so that it moves with the original layer. Of course, don't forget to enable the motion blur for the clone stamping and the overall composition. I know. There are a lot of steps, but you can't deny it's a super cool effect. Okay, let's immediately jump into the next effect. For this, you can take a shot of your actor acting like he's being possessed. Again, film from a tripod. Now for the hands that are going to lay underneath the skin, we did something special. We used a big white balloon and tightened this around a bucket. Of course, this bucket needs two holes, otherwise you can't put your hand into it. So remove the bottom. Now place your bucket on the tripod, use some side lighting so you get a clear and hard shadow, and start with putting your hand against the balloon. This will already give you a feeling that something wants to escape from the bucket. Now let's go into After Effects and put the shot of your actor into a new composition. The first thing you now can do is duplicate the layer. Next up, select the lower layer and again track the motion of it. After this, you can put the shot of your balloon hand on top of everything. Now mask out everything around the white balloon, then position and scale it wherever you want. The following step is linking the balloon hand to the motion of your actor. So select the null object and duplicate it. Now link the balloon hand to the duplicated null object. After this, you can select them both, right-click on them and select Pre-compose. To recreate the effect of something underneath your skin, we are going to need a bump map. So in the Effects and Presets panel, we are going to look for the CC glass effect. Drag this effect to the duplicate of your actor layer, and now within the Effects control panel, open up the surface option of the CC glass effect. Here you can set the bump map to the pre-composed balloon hand layer. For a property, you can leave it on the lightness option. set the height to 100, and now you can start playing around with the light settings. Use the light height to determine how prominent the displacement will look, and with the shading options, you can do some extra tweaking. Just play around with the settings until you have something you like. The very last step you now need to do is mask out a strange circle around the hand. Again, feather the mask, and you can play with the expansion to be sure that the circle is gone. Now you can repeat this process as many times as you want to create more skin displacements. And you know what they say? Like with every possession, the more demons, the better. Guys, I lied to you. We aren't going to show you two effects. We are going to show you three effects. The last effect that we are explaining is the hand coming out of your mouth. It's quite simple, but you need to mask a lot. For the shots, you need one with the actor where he opens up his mouth. We recreated the original shot, where an arm grabs the actor's head from behind and pulls him backwards. Now for the hand coming out of the actor's mouth, we filmed it in the same location, so that the lighting is completely the same. We also use a green screen to make it ourselves easier. A tip I can give you: don't move your hand too much. Just hold it still and keep your fingers together. Then move your fingers a little, but not too crazy. Now in After Effects, it's quite simple. Place your hand shot above your actor. Key out the green and place it on the position where you want it to start. If needed, you can also scale it to fit in the actor's mouth. Create a mask so that only a small part of the fingers are visible in the mouth. Next up, enable the animation for the position, scale, and the mask pad. Move further in time and let the hand come out of the actor's mouth. Move it up with the position, use the scale if needed, and adjust the mask so that it follows the lips. As you can see, it's quite an easy effect, but the masking will take some time to get it right.
Get right in.
And that was it for today, guys. I hope you liked the three effects we made for you. Hit the bell icon if you want to keep learning every week. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support. And like always, stay creative. So if you want to check out Storyblocks Video and start downloading right away, click in the first description in the link below. What the f***? From After Effects. This is a tool. This is a...